Hello students, in this session I would like to explain concepts of quadratic equations and expressions, and this session will be useful for the students who are preparing for JE Mains as well as advanced. Now let us start with the definition of a polynomial. So what is the definition of a polynomial? So when I say a polynomial, I need to understand polynomial of degree, for example, n. So what is the definition of a polynomial of degree n? So it's very simple. An equation of this type, a naught into x power n, a1 into x power n minus 1 plus a2 into x power n minus 2 up to an equals to 0 is called a polynomial of degree n, provided a0 is not equals to 0 and n is a non-negative integer. N cannot be a negative number, a negative integer. And all these ai's like a0, a1 up to an are some real constants or complex constants. So I am just defining a polynomial. It could be a real polynomial or complex polynomial. But most of the times in this chapter, we will be discussing about a real polynomial. So this is the definition of polynomial. Now, to understand, now by using the definition of a polynomial, I would like to define what is a quadratic equation or expression. Now, if I write down a polynomial of degree n, the same equation, a0 into x power n, a1 into x power n minus 1, plus a2 into x power n minus 2, up to a n minus 1 into x, a n minus 2 x square, a n minus 1 into x plus a n equals to 0. So this is a simple nth degree polynomial. Now, if you observe this polynomial equation, and if I take only this part, it is like a n minus 1 times of x plus a n equals to 0. So definitely this is called as a linear equation, as linear equation is a polynomial of degree 1, because the highest power present in this equation is 1, so that is the degree of a polynomial. Now similarly, if I take from x square, a n minus 2 into x square plus a n minus 1 into x plus a n equals to 0. Now this is called as quadratic equation. Quad means 2, obviously, because the degree of this polynomial is 2, and however a n minus 2 is not equals to 0, and obviously in this case a n minus 1 is not equals to 0. That means for the polynomial to be meaningful, at least one of the coefficients a naught, a1, a top to an should be not equal to 0. So this is the definition of a quadratic equation. So in general, any equation of this type, ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0, is called a quadratic equation, where a is not equals to 0, where a, b, c are some constants. Now, after defining quadratic equation, and obviously quadratic expression is nothing but ax square plus bx plus c, the first thing will be solution of that quadratic equation. When I say ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0, so this is a polynomial of second degree, and definitely this equation cannot have more than two roots. So for example, this equation has two roots, alpha and beta. And obviously, when we are speaking about the roots of the quadratic equation, we will get three cases based on the value of discriminant. So in quadratic equations, this is one of the important terms which determines the nature of the roots of the quadratic equation, and usually we denote it by d or delta. So this is given as b square minus 4ac. I think in your lower classes you already know the formula to find the roots of the quadratic equation. We call it as Sridharacharya's formula, and it is given by minus b plus or minus root b square minus 4ac by 2a. So the nature of the roots of this quadratic equation is determined by the value of b square minus 4ac. So obviously there will be three cases. This b square minus 4ac can be positive, this b square minus 4ac can be equals to 0, and this b square minus 4ac can be less than 0. So now, whenever discriminant is greater than 0, we say that quadratic equation has two distinct roots which are real. So roots are real and distinct. Similarly, if b square minus 4ac is equals to 0, definitely this total term will be 0, so you get only x equals to minus b by 2. That means you are getting only one root. So we say that roots are real and equal. So whenever discriminant is equals to 0, you will get real roots. Similarly, if discriminant is less than 0, which means that you will get negative under the square root, so which means that you will get the complex roots. So roots are complex. So this is the nature of the roots of the quadratic equation. So by determining the sign of discriminant b square minus 4ac, we can determine the nature of the roots of the quadratic equation. So once again, if discriminant is greater than 0, roots are real and distinct. If the discriminant is equals to 0, roots are real and equal. And if discriminant is less than 0, roots are complex. Now, so this is about nature of the roots of the quadratic equation. One more thing, this is the quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0. And let me assume this quadratic equation has two roots, alpha and beta. Alpha and beta are the roots of the quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0. Now if ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0 has two roots, alpha and beta, now I'll get one formula which is very very important. One is sum of the roots, another one is product of the roots. So which means that it is very simple. When I say alpha and beta are the roots of this equation, it implies x minus alpha and x minus beta will be the factors of this quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c, which means that I can write this one as, if I take a common, x square plus b by a into x plus c by a is equals to x a times of x minus alpha into x minus beta. So if you compare and if you multiply, obviously you will get alpha plus beta as minus b by a, alpha beta as c by a. So this is important formula in quadratic equations. Sum of the roots is equals to minus b by a, product of the roots is equals to c by a, and these two formulas are very very important. However, formulas are very easy, but their application is very very important, and there are so many questions which were asked in JEE mains based on this simple sum of the roots and product of the roots formulas. But you have to apply these two formulas to the new situations. Now, having understood the sum of the roots and the product of the roots, let us try to understand how to find the difference of the roots. So this is some of the roots and this is product of the roots. Now I want to find out the difference of the roots, that is modulus of alpha minus beta. It is like absolute difference. Now obviously, to find the difference of two roots, if you know alpha plus beta and alpha beta, finding alpha minus beta is pretty simple. I can write alpha minus beta whole square as alpha plus beta whole square minus 4 alpha beta, which is equals to b square by a square minus 4c by a, which is nothing but b square minus 4ac by a square. So obviously it will be equal to, if you take square root both sides, modulus of alpha minus beta equal to square root of d by modulus of a. So this is also one of the useful formulas in quadratic equations. So this is the formula to find the difference of the roots. Square root of discriminant by modulus of a. Now, having understood the sum of the roots and the product of the roots of a quadratic equation, let us move to another concept, and which is very simple concept. Let me assume again the same quadratic equation, ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0. Now, obviously a is not equals to 0. Obviously, quadratic equation cannot have more than two roots. But can we look for the possibility where this quadratic equation is defined for all values of x? In fact, all the values of domain of this expression. So obviously, what is the domain of this quadratic expression? All real numbers, because this is defined for all real numbers. Now I want to check in what case, in which case this quadratic equation is satisfied by more than two roots. That means, is it possible to have more than two roots for this quadratic equation? Yes, it is possible if a equal to b equal to c equals to 0 simultaneously. Because if a equal to b equal to c equals to 0, then quadratic equation ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0 is true for all real numbers. Such type of quadratic equations are called as identity. So this particular quadratic equation is called as identity in x. In fact, it is called as quadratic identity. That is, if a quadratic equation is satisfied by more than two values of x, that means, see, if you look at this one, if a equals to b equals to c equals to 0, irrespective of the value of x, this expression will become 0, which means that this quadratic equation is satisfied for all real numbers x. That's why this expression is called as identity in x. So when I say that a quadratic expression is an identity, it means that coefficient of x square, coefficient of x and the constant are equals to 0 simultaneously. So this is one of the important concepts in quadratic equations and expressions. Now let's move on. One more thing. Again, if I consider the same quadratic equation, ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0, and if a, b, c are rational numbers. Now, I will consider the case, if d is greater than 0 and it is a perfect square. This is also one of the important points related to nature of the roots of the quadratic equation. If discriminant is greater than 0, obviously we will get two distinct and real roots, and it is a perfect square. So what will happen? Obviously, the roots are real and rational. By using this formula, x equal to minus b plus or minus square root of d by 2a. If b is a perfect square, definitely here you will get some constant. So definitely you will get minus b plus something by 2a, minus b minus something by 2a. So definitely these roots will be rational. So whenever the roots are rational for a quadratic equation, then d must be a perfect square. So this is one point which you need to remember. And there is another point. If d is greater than 0 and it is not a perfect square, so obviously if d is not a perfect square, you will get something like this, minus b by 2a plus r minus root d by 2a. So here you will get some value and here you will get some value. That is, the roots will be of this form. It is like p plus root q, p minus root q, isn't it? Because here you will get irrational roots. So here you will get irrational roots. And irrational roots always occur in conjugate pairs, which means that if p plus root q is one root of the quadratic equation, and obviously p minus root q will be the other root. So in any problem, if he mentions p plus root q or 2 plus root 3 is root of a quadratic expression, then straight away you can write 2 minus root 3 is also another root of the quadratic equation. So these two points are very, very important. If d is greater than 0 and it is a perfect square, then the roots are rational. And if d is greater than 0 and it is not a perfect square, then the roots are irrational. Now, having understood this, let me tell you another point related to this one. If discriminant is less than 0, then again you get obviously imaginary roots, in fact complex roots. It will be something like this, minus b by 2a plus or minus root d by 2a. Since d is less than 0, definitely you will get minus b by 2a plus or minus, since square root of an empty number, you will get I times something, which means that you will get imaginary roots, and those imaginary roots are complex conjugate pairs, just like irrational roots. That is, roots will be of this form, p plus iq, p minus iq. That means, if for a quadratic equation, if discriminant is less than 0, then the roots always occur in conjugate complex pairs. That is, if he mentions 2 plus I is one root. So obviously 2 minus I will be the other root, or vice versa. I hope this is clear. So these are few points related to nature of the roots of the quadratic equation. Now, well, let us try to solve one question based on this nature of the roots, or sum of the roots and product of the roots of the quadratic equation. He mentioned, if alpha comma beta are the roots of ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0, and c is not equals to 0, then the value of 1 by a alpha plus b whole square plus 1 by a beta plus b whole square in terms of a, b, c. So this is the question. If alpha comma beta are the roots of ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0, and c is not equals to 0, then 1 by a alpha plus b whole square plus 1 by a beta plus b whole square in terms of a, b and c. Now look at this question and let us look into this question and let's try to solve this. See here, He said alpha and beta are the roots of this equation. So usually whenever alpha and beta are the roots of the quadratic equation, we have the tendency to write sum of the roots and product of the roots, and we will try to use that sum of the roots and product of the roots in this expression. But here it is not a simple expression actually. Now solution: ax square plus bx plus c equals to 0. He said alpha and beta are the roots of this equation. Now let me write sum of the roots and product of the roots, and let's see if this is useful in getting the answer for this particular equation. Now if I try to use this alpha plus beta and alpha beta, you have to simplify this one, you have to take LCM, and it will be very big. Instead, what I do is, and this is very very important, root means that particular value will satisfy this quadratic equation. That is, alpha is a root of this equation, which means that alpha will satisfy this equation. That means if I substitute alpha in this expression, I'll get 0. That is, I can write it as a alpha square plus b alpha plus c equals to 0. Similarly, a beta square plus b beta plus c equals to 0. Now, from this one, I'll write this one as a alpha square plus b alpha equal to minus c, a beta square plus b beta equal to minus c. Now, I'll erase this. Now the question is 1 by a alpha plus b whole square plus 1 by a beta plus b whole square. Now this is equals to, now if you observe this one, if I take alpha common, I'll get a alpha plus b equal to minus c. Similarly here, if I take beta common, I'll get a beta plus b equal to minus c. Now obviously here, 1 by, can I replace a alpha plus b by minus c by alpha? If I bring this alpha to the right side, I'll get minus c by a whole square plus 1 by minus c by, sorry, this is alpha, minus c by beta whole square. Now from here I'll continue the simplification. It will be alpha square by c square plus beta square by c square. Now if I continue, this will be alpha square plus beta square by c square, which is equals to, now I can use sum of the roots and product of the roots, alpha plus beta whole square minus 2 alpha beta by c square, because alpha square plus beta square can be written as alpha plus beta whole square minus 2 alpha beta by c square. Now we know alpha plus beta is minus b by a whole square minus this is 2 c by a by c square. Now after taking LCM and if I simplify this one, b square minus 2ac by a square c square. So this is the final answer to this question. See, now here the thing is, it's not about getting the right answer always, it's about understanding the question. He said alpha and beta are the roots of this equation, and we are asked to find the value of this expression. If I directly take LCM and if I try to simplify this one, it would have been more lengthier, obviously, because it is a alpha plus beta whole square. So it will be a square alpha square plus b square plus 2ab alpha. Again, it would have been more and more lengthier. But instead, here we did something like this. Since alpha is the root of this expression, alpha will satisfy this equation. Similarly, beta is the root of this equation, beta will satisfy this one. So I used alpha in this equation and beta in this equation, and by using those equations, I tried to find a alpha plus beta and a beta plus b. And then I substituted the values of these two expressions here, and then I used sum of the roots and product of the roots, then I got the answer. Right. Now, let us try to look at some questions which were asked in previous JEE mains from this particular chapter. See here, the question is something like this. If lambda be the ratio of the roots of the quadratic equation in x, if lambda be the ratio of the roots of the quadratic equation 3m square x square plus m into m minus 4 into x plus 2 equal to 0, then the least value of m then the least value of m for which lambda plus 1 by lambda equal to 1. And here the options are something like this: minus 2 plus root 2, 4 minus 3 root 2, 2 minus root 3, 4 minus 2 root 3. Now if you observe this question, he said if lambda be the ratio of the roots of the quadratic equation 3m square x square plus m into m minus 4 into x plus 2 equals to 0, then the least value of m, this is a question, that is we need to find the minimum value of m for which lambda plus 1 by lambda equals to 1. Now to answer this question, first he said lambda is the ratio of the roots of this quadratic equation. Actually I do not know the roots of this equation, so what I do is I assume two roots. Here the question is not difficult, but as I said already, it's not about remembering sum of the roots and product of the roots formulas. You need to apply those formulas in the new situations. Now let me assume alpha and beta are the roots of this particular quadratic equation, and according to the given problem, lambda is the ratio of the roots of this quadratic equation, isn't it? Now I'll use sum of the roots minus m into m minus 4 by 3m square, product of the roots 2 by 3m square. Now and he gave one more condition, lambda plus 1 by lambda equal to 1. Now if I substitute alpha by beta in this equation, I'll get alpha by beta plus beta by alpha equal to 1. Now from this equation I'll get, if I take LCM, alpha square plus beta square by alpha beta equal to 1. Now from this one, alpha square plus beta square equal to alpha beta. Now I can write this one as alpha plus beta whole square minus 2 alpha beta. If I bring minus 2 alpha beta this side, I get 3 alpha beta. Now obviously if I cancel this one, I will get minus of m minus 4 by 3m. Now if I substitute alpha plus beta here, I will get m minus 4 whole square, because square is there, you don't get negative term, by 9m square equal to, what is 3 alpha beta? It will be 2 by m square. So m square and m square will be cancelled. Now if I simplify this one, I will get m minus 4 whole square is equals to 18. Now this is a quadratic equation m. Now we need to find the least value of m. So that is m minus 4 equal to plus or minus, what is this value? Root 18. That is m equal to 4 plus or minus 29s are, so this will be 3 root 2. Now what are the options he has given? Let me write the options here. First option is minus 2 plus root 2, and the second option is 4 minus 3 root 2, and the third option is 2 minus root 3, and the fourth option is 4 minus 2 root 3. So here we got two values. One is 4 plus 3 root 2 and then the other is 4 minus 3 root 2. And obviously, according to the given options, 4 minus 3 root 2 will be the minimum value. So this is the answer. And by the way, this question was asked in JEE 2019, JEE Mains. So that's it for today's session. Thank you so much.